Hey, I'm here at the library, and there was some interest in a video on just hanging out at the library, looking through some of the books, and there are some technical challenges here. I've only got the one hand to look at books with, but we'll see if I can manage it. I wasn't entirely sure where to start. This is the nonfiction section, and there's just so much to choose from. On here we have poetry. That's a good place to start. Haiku in English, the first 100 years. An empty elevator opens, closes. Is that a haiku? I thought they had a specific syllable count. Most of these others do. Oh. This one is nice. The white of her neck. As she lifts her hair for me to undo her dress. Certainly conjures an image, a scene. Now the melody in the pattern of shadows, one shadow behind. I don't know what that one means. Moonlit, the empty slot in the knife block, bolted and chained the way to the mountains. Rain, cairn, crow. Gale, force, wind, the shrieks of gulls flying in place. It's another one that evokes an image. Some of these, though, are much less obviously descriptive, kind of a mystery. I feel like that was a good place to start. Let's see. Go over here. This one is called Lost Moon. The Perilous Voyage of Apollo 13. I'll just flip to a random page. Let's see. Oh, it's much more narrative than I expected. It's look at that, it's like a novel, but nonfiction, I guess that would make it like a memoir. Oh, some pictures. Astronauts. Oh, he landed in the ocean. Cool. How exciting. I love space flight. I think it's a wonderful ambition. I want to explore the universe. We're back to narrative again. I probably won't read through it, but it's there if I ever get the urge. Alright, moving on. We have some gardening. Let's see what's... This one is deer-resistant landscaping. If you have trouble with deer in your yard, as well as rabbits, bears, and raccoons, then that's quite the area you live. Let's Let's see. First, we've got some information about deers. Deer, I guess, is the plural. About their breeding and reproduction and that combat between males. That's exciting. Let's see, these are different plants. The deer avoided these plants, but they ate the corn cobs. I guess these are also favorite foods of deer. How cute. Here's some wire mesh fencing. Good book. I tell you what, I would love to live in a place where I have where all these animals are my pests. That sounds great. As it is, I've got let's see, what do I have at home? I've got cockroaches, house flies, spiders. That's about it. Oh, here we have sports. I'm not a sports person. It's not like my favorite topic, but I guess I'm in this section. I should at least look at it. Let's learn how to play our best golf now. Multiple authors of the best-selling Every Shot Must Have a Purpose. They have a whole system here. When you're in the play box, you have to be fully engaged in hitting the golf shot at hand. And that is why the first of the 8 essential playing skills for peak performance is the concept of the play box. This essential tops your list of priorities. The other 7 are of equal importance to one another, but it is through mastering the play box skills that peak performance is achieved. There's lots of things in the world to achieve excellence in, and I guess golf is certainly one of them. It's never one I've ever considered, but if you take it seriously, there are books out there for you. Great players have a positive voice in their head, so should you. And then give an example of the kind of conversation you might want to have with yourself. I would bet that this sort of thing is a good practice for all sorts of different skills. Positivity and that sort of, what is it, Jake from Adventure Time says, sucking at something is the first step to being sort of good at something. You've got to integrate that into your attitude, man, or you're never going to get there. Chapter 5. Feel your tempo, dance to its rhythm. A conductor and pianist here says, the tempo is the suitcase. If the suitcase is too small, everything is completely wrinkled. If the tempo is too fast, everything becomes so scrambled you can't understand it. Sounds like my brain. Well, golf philosophy, it's good. Let's see. Over here is stuff about diet. So, whole food, don't drink milk, cookbooks. Italian, Roman cookbooks. Balance and Harmony, The Secrets of Asian Cooking. Oh, this book is huge. Okay, we're gonna have to do this. It's enough for, oh my goodness. and it really is a cookbook, although it goes into more detail. This is like the sort of detail that a food blog goes into. Wonton soup with noodles, look. Oh no, that looks delicious. Oh crap, this was a bad idea. Braised shiitake mushrooms. Do they have a picture of that one? I'm getting hungry. What is this? Crispy blue eye? Marinated in red bean curd. That might not be the same. Fried eggs with spicy tamarind dressing. Man, I don't remember the last time I had red bean curd. It's been a while. Tea smoking. I don't know what's going on in this lovely art, but she looks happy. Tea smoke. What does that mean? There's some sort of food preparation method called tea smoking. Let's see, here's a tea smoke mix. Jasmine tea leaves, brown sugar, rice. You mix it together and keep it in an airtight container. I don't know. It doesn't go into more detail. Here's smoked duck, if you're into that sort of thing. It looks a little burned. Maybe it's supposed to be like that. You start by removing all the fat from the duck cavity. I think really we should move on. Okay. Yeah. It's definitely making me hungry. This sells well as a cookbook, I'd say, because just looking through it, you start getting hungry for everything and want to make all the food. Oh my, and then it's interspersed with some lovely art. This just seems like a great book. What are those clams? Yum, yum, yum. Alright, for the welfare of my own stomach, I've gotta maybe stop looking at this one. Rice with coconut cream. Oh, okay. Great. Next time I host a dinner party, I'm coming to this section of the library. Oh, it's a Nordic cookbook if you're into Vikings. Alright, what else do we have? Oh, we've got some music. This is an entire section on Jimi Hendrix. I think a lot of these are memoirs or something. Pearl Jam, U2, David Bowie. U.S. history. Let's see. What is this? This one sounds like fiction. 22 Tales from the Outer Limits of Literature. Terrifying Tales. These are not nonfiction, as far as I know. Stories of Terror and Madness from Stephen King, I like his stuff. Whitley Strieber, he wrote that book about alien communion. It terrified me when I was a kid. But it is, it's just fiction. So, I'm not sure why it's in this section, but maybe they're trying to preserve it for antiquity. Let's see. Brains, a zombie memoir. Looks like another cookbook. It's, yeah, just more fiction. I found the fiction section of the nonfiction. That's okay, but I think I'll move on. Encyclopedia Neurotica. Oh, it's like an actual encyclopedia. Adolescent, one who suffers from hormone-induced dementia. German for a kind of fearful worry, a deep existential anxiety. See also Abyss, Dark Night of the Soul, Human Condition, Undertoad. Common sense, instinctive good judgment. Sadly, it is regarded a quaint notion that the shoals of life can be successfully navigated with the sturdy rudder of non-academic wisdom. See also intellectual boob. Ennui. Extreme boredom, weariness, emptiness of spirit. One of ennui's most terrible components is the overwhelming feeling of ennui that comes over you when you try to explain it. Guideline creep. Maddening tendency of experts to raise the bar on health habit standards just when you thought you were doing okay. Hypergraphia, uncontrollable urge to write, often exhibited by people with temporal lobe epilepsy. Unfortunately, the compulsion is rarely accompanied by talent. So we've got a modern dictionary here, or encyclopedia about anxieties and boredoms and complaints of all sorts. All right, here's some more poems. This one is from, see, these are specific. The Russian poets. I keep my eyes closed. Do not rush me. You, fire, power, might, for it is too early. I have lived through many years, and as in this half dream, I felt I was attaining the moving frontier. Beyond which color and sound come true, and the things of this earth are united. Do not yet force me to open my lips. Let me trust, and I believe I will attain. Let me linger here in Mittelbergheim. Hmm. My beard is thick, my eyelids half cover, my eyes, as with those who know the value of visible things. Keep quiet, as is proper for a man who has learned that the human heart holds more than speech does. I have left behind my native land, home, and public office. Not that I looked for profit or adventure. I am no foreigner on board a ship. My plain face, the face of a tax collector, merchant, or soldier, makes me one of the crowd. Nor do I refuse to pay due homage to local gods, and I eat what others eat. About myself, this much will suffice. I saw hungry dogs lengthening and shortening their muzzles, and changing from mongrels to greyhounds, then dachshunds, as if to signify they were perhaps not quite dogs. Huge flocks of crows, freezing in midair, exploded under the clouds. Well, I think this is been a pretty good library visit. Began and ended with poetry, and got to look at some fun things. Thanks for joining me. I had a lot of fun looking through books with you. Maybe we can do it again soon sometime. For now, I'll talk to you later.